In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the Raspberry Pi with Windows 10 IoT Core to read Modbus and sensor data.
Okay, so what I have here is this industrial controller from Opto22. So I've got this potentiometer mapped to a Modbus address that we'll be reading using the Raspberry Pi. And then here I've got this DHT11 sensor module that measures temperature and humidity and communicates using a one-wire protocol. So I will also be reading those values using the Raspberry Pi.
At the end of this demo, we'll have an app that graphically shows the value of temperature and humidity from our DHT11 sensor and our Modbus TCP value from the industrial controller, as you can see on the display.
Okay, let's create a blank universal Windows project. Now our project has been created. We'll begin by connecting to our industrial controller to read the potentiometer Modbus address using Modbus TCP. And to do that, we must first install a package for Modbus communication, particularly for Universal Windows app. Okay, so that's done. Now let's go to our main page C# file, which is the code that first executes when our app starts running. Now, I want our app to read sensor data every second, so I'll create a timer. And then on initialization, I'll specify the 1 second time span for my timer, specify a method for handling the timer, and then start the timer. And then I'll put my timer method here. Now for my Modbus communication, I'll first include the necessary assembly reference. And then I declare my variables. I've got my input data, my controller slave address, my TCP client master, and the Modbus data for storing the conversion from word to float, and my variable for the result. And then here I'll put my method for connecting to the Modbus client. So here I'm creating a client with the IP address of my controller and a port 502. And then here I'm creating the Modbus master, which is my Raspberry Pi. And then I'll call my connect method here on initialization. And then I'll put my method for reading Modbus. And then another one for converting the 2 bytes of Modbus into a float. And then when that is done, I'll call the read Modbus method every second. Now that's all for our Modbus. We move on to our DHT11 sensor module. First of all, we must include the package that allows us to talk to the sensor module via its one-wire protocol. Okay, so we've got our package installed. Now we go back to our C# file, and then here we add the assembly reference for our sensor module and the GPIO pins of the Pi. And then we go on to add the variables for communicating with my DHT11 sensor module. So here I've got that one wire connected to pin number 4, GPIO pin number 4 of the Pi. And then here I'm instantiating a type of DHT, and then I'm also instantiating a GPIO pin type. And then we also need to initialize the DHT11 sensor by opening the pin number 4 and then setting it as an input pin. And then we put the method that does the actual reading of the temperature and humidity data. And then finally, we also call the sensor method after every 1 second. Now we have all the code required to read Modbus and sensor data, but then we need to be able to visualize it graphically. So we go to our XAML page. Now, our project comes with standard controls, such as your buttons and stuff, but if we need dashboard controls, such as the radial gauge we want to use, we must add a UI package. And then when that is complete, we reference that package on our XAML page. And then I add this code here, which is basically, I'm creating a grid with 3 columns and 2 rows. Then in the first row, I'm putting my 3 radial gauges. And then in the second row, I'm putting the labels. And then finally, I go back to my C# code to include the code for updating these radial gauges. And then from here, I make sure that ARM processor is selected and remote machine is selected here, and then confirm the IP address of my Raspberry Pi. And then I deploy.
Okay, so as you can see, our app is running. So I'll turn the potentiometer up and breathe into the sensor module.
Okay, so if you need the source code for this demo, please feel free to shoot me a message or send it to you. Otherwise, thanks for watching. If you found it useful, please share it with your connections and don't forget to subscribe on YouTube.